Hi, gang. I'm glad you're all here. Thank you for joining me. There was a magnitude 5.5 earthquake not too long ago. It was 69 kilometers east of the city of Huailin, there by Taiwan. 20 people so far have reportedly felt this earthquake. Taiwan is located at the boundary between the Philippine Sea Plate to the east and the Eurasian Plate to the west, with a convergence rate of about 80 millimeters a year, a little more than 3 inches. The plate boundary is rather complex since it comprises of two subduction zones. Today's earthquakes were not far from January 3rd's earthquake of a magnitude 6.2. 64 people reported feeling that 6.2, and it was a thrust earthquake just like today. Today was a thrust earthquake, actually a reverse thrust earthquake. The only difference between a reverse thrust earthquake and a thrust earthquake is the angle of dip. Here is an image of today's earthquake. Yeah, it's a reverse thrust earthquake. On Geoscope, it shows how the one plate moved and created the other one to pop up. Some of the felt reports on EMSE: strong but extremely short. This one said it was a gentle shake. Another one, a little shake. But this one here, they were on the sixth floor of a sky rise, and it says nice shake on the sixth floor. Enjoying some wine when it started to shake. Lasted for a while, but not too bad. A slow rumble, so they actually heard it. Another one, wobble on the third floor. 20th floor, smooth rolling for about 20 seconds. Heard my hangers rattling and thought it was a ghost at first. Only lasted a few seconds. Now this one here says it was a light shake on the second floor, but it lasted a long time though. An earthquake shake for about a minute. They were 161 kilometers from where the earthquake occurred. So that would be about 100 miles northwest. Another one, 229 miles southwest. So that would be about 142 miles southwest. Earthquake felt. Clear shaking of bed lasted around 15 seconds. Just outside of Taiwan. And that's all they have. Now on the shake report for USGS, Taiwan is way down over here. Looks like most of the reports came from Taipei. USGS gave it an intensity level of 6, which means it lasted 5 to 8 seconds. Felt by many. Many were frightened and ran outdoors. Some heavy furniture moved. A few instances of fallen plaster and damage to chimneys. Now, in 1999, there was a 7.6 or 7.7 earthquake. There was over 2,415 deaths. 11,300 people were injured, 29 missing, and it was originally called the Chichi earthquake. Later, the Chichi earthquake was renamed and changed to Gigi earthquake. There evidently is a fault zone that travels through here that was locked, and yeah, it ruptured. They say that this fault zone stores up the energy and releases it between every 200 to 250 years. And then up over here somewhere in 1935, there was a magnitude 7.0. I'll have to look up the location of that earthquake. I have an arrow drawn showing the direction that these plates are moving and the subduction. Like I said, we have the Philippine Sea Plate going underneath the Eurasian Plate, sending prayers. So what are your thoughts? Put those comments down below. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Always be prepared for some sort of disaster. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless you. Bye.